Hello everyone, this is Sam from DATEC Studios. In this video, I want to talk about paint deformation in 3D Studio Max. I maximize my perspective view from create, geometry, create a plane, press F4 to see edge faces, convert to editable poly, and press Ctrl M for a couple of times to increase subdivision. If you're using 3D Studio Max 2012 or earlier version, there are two options to use paint deformation. You can use ribbon in freeform section, or simply find paint deformation rollout in command panel. As you see, there are three buttons in top of paint deformation: push pull, relax, and revert. I enable push and pull button and start painting. By default, push operator enabled, which means when you start painting, your geometry surface will increase height based on normal directions. If I hold Alt or Option key on a Mac and start dragging, you enabled pull operator, which means you decrease height of geometry surface. If you like your deformations, you could press commit button, else press cancel to reset deformations. There are three value parameters here, which contains push-pull value, brush size, and brush strength. I enable push and pull button. Push and pull value by default set on 10. Because my 3D Studio Max unit measurement set on centimeter, so push and pull value set on 10 centimeter. For example, if I set my push and pull value to 20 centimeter and start painting on the surface, your geometry surface where you paint it exactly increase height 20 centimeter based on your normal direction. I can create a box here and change the color and set height to 20 centimeter. As you see, your geometry height increased exactly 20 centimeter. All right, I delete that box and going to modify panel again. Brush size is self-explanatory. By increasing brush size, you could push or pull larger area or decrease the size, for example, something around 6, your brush size reduced. Alright, I set on 20 again. And the last parameter here is brush strength, which it is multiply of brush, push, and pull value. For example, my push and pull value is already set on 20 centimeter. If I decrease value of brush strength to 0.5, this time when I'm starting dragging on geometry surface, instead of increase height immediately to 20 centimeter, slowly increase the height. I can say brush strength works like brush flow in some applications like Adobe Photoshop. So if I decrease the value, for example 0.1, now if I start painting, as you see, your geometry push or pull increase slowly. Allow me to increase brush strength like 0.3 and cancel deformations. Note that when I start push or pull my geometry surface, while you holding down left mouse button, maximum height you will achieve is 20 centimeter. If you want to increase more height, you should release your left mouse button and again start dragging to another 20 centimeter step. So if I set my brush strength to 1 and start dragging by push and pull value. While you're single dragging to painting, your maximum height will equal to push and pull value. If you need more height, you should release your left mouse button and start dragging again. Relax button also is self-explanatory. If I click on relax button and start painting, your jagged hard edges start to smoothing. And the third button here is revert. If you press cancel, your old deformations will undo. But if you select revert button, you could just take back some part of deformations you applied. As you see, it's going back to original shape. And I see very harsh edges, so start using relax. There are few useful shortcuts here I will mention to you. I select push and pull button. If you hold down the shift control or shift command on a Mac and drag up, you can increase your brush size. If bring down, you could decrease your brush size. So shift and control or shift and command and drag will change your brush size. If you hold down the alt and shift or option and shift on a Mac and start to dragging, you could set brush strength value. I mentioned before, if you start painting with push and pull button, by default your operator is push. If you hold down the alt or option key, your operator switch to pull. And lastly, if you hold down the control key, temporarily revert operator will active, so you could bring back all your deformations anywhere on your surface geometry you want. I cancel to undo all my deformations on this geometry and will mention one more tip here. I select push and pull button and click. As you see, my brush has fall off, or we could say it is soft brush. If I click on brush options in painter options window, you can see this linear curve, which the left side represents center of your brush and right side represents border of your brush. So because we have a curve here from 1 to value 0, so middle of your brush strength value is 1 and slowly decrease to reach 0. Because of that, you have a soft brush. If I select the right side of this brush and set the value to 1, now we have a straight line. And if I click on my surface geometry, as you see, now we have very hard edge. Of course, like any other curve editors, you could increase your points middle of this line. For example, I add 2 more here and move these 2 points to reach close about 0. Now if I analyze before I start painting, we have brush strength 1 slowly decrease to reach 0. This middle of this curve, or better to say brush, we don't have any strength value. And by reaching to the end of this brush outline, again we increase the value to reach 1. So I cancel here, and if I start to click on my geometry, as you see, we change our brush values. I could delete all of these, increase only 1 point in the middle, and 0.5 to make sure exactly middle of the brush. And now I select both of two sides of brush and set 0. What happens here? Now again, the center of brush has 0 value, start to go in the maximum strength value to 1 and again 0. I click to see the result. Of course, we could make this corner smooth. I right click on that corner and select Bezier Smooth. Now click once. That's enough for today. If you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe for more videos. Thank you.